Welcome back to my show. I'm Lady Ellerby, and today we're going to be talking about this surprise Beyonce tour, Bruno Mars and cultural appropriation, and I'm going to give you my song of the day. Okay, guys, so Beyonce has done it again. She has hit us with another surprise, okay? She has a tour coming up. Starting June, she's going to be in Europe and United States. But I'm very happy for the girl. You know, B is my homie for life. I'm in the Beehive. But can she tell her real fans first that she has a surprise concert coming up? I mean, I know it sounds a little weird. But you know what happens? All the people who don't really care about Beyonce in real life go and buy all the tickets early because they have city card, because they have whatever credit card they're supposed to have. And then they sell the tickets back to the true fans at unreasonable prices. Beyonce, I'm gonna need for you to do something different. Get us a little secret code. Let us know 3 days ahead if we went to a concert before I actually went. Find out. Like, I know it's gonna take a lot of work. But we need those tickets before everybody else. Now, my friend tried to help me get some tickets because she always has a little inside scoop. But Beyonce tickets, but you know, I'm not gonna do it. I mean, I thought about going to Amsterdam. That would be awesome. But let's talk about these ticket prices. Okay, so the ticket prices range because right now they're being sold by, you know, resale, like $1,500 for terrible seats. I looked up on Tidal some concert tickets in Amsterdam, and they range from $30 to $177. Euros, but that maximum amount is like $217 in euros. I looked that up. I know. Second, when is this album coming out? I guess you're gonna have us waiting until June because that's when your tour actually starts in Europe. But where's the music? Because I went to the first On the Run tour, it was awesome, it was perfect. And I know Jay-Z did his little album, but Beyonce, so we can get back to dancing again and remembering all these lyrics so we can be ready so that when we're at the concert, we can sing all the songs. You know how it go. So it's been in the news that our wonderful, amazing, talented, smooth, debonair Bruno Mars has been accused of cultural appropriation. Now guys, let me tell you this. If can't nobody do it, Bruno can do it. That little guy is smooth. Like, he can hit those moves. He on beat, swinging that body. Bruno Mars is from the United States. He's Hawaiian. And last I checked, Hawaiian was a little bit mad. He in here. He ain't appropriating any culture. He is a brown man who was raised doing this type of music, jazz and whatever, performing for his family. So he has the base. There is no appropriation. Now, if he was Justin Timberlake, Justin Bieber, Eminem, obvious cultural appropriation. But we're talking about Bruno here. His music style encompasses pop, funk, R&B, hip hop. He has a little bit of everything in his music. He has a live jazz band standing behind him. I need for people to leave him alone and let that man make the music that he knows how to make. Everybody's talking about how somebody's copying, everybody's jocking. Oh, but music is a very slow or fast progression. Everybody takes a little something from somewhere and builds onto it to create their own thing. You, if you out there, you make music, you've done that. You've listened to some music, you've heard it, he's like, oh, I really like this. Now let me go create something, not the exact same thing, but it's inspired. Everyone is inspired by something that causes them to go out and create something on their own. But guys, leave Bruno alone. It's not cultural appropriation. And my song of the day is the Django Jane. Janelle Monáe is coming out with a new album in June. I mean, June, it's taking so long. She's already put out 2 or 3 songs, I think it's just 2, that she made videos for also, and they are awesome. So if you guys haven't checked those videos out, check the videos out, check the song out, because they're awesome. Janelle Monáe has really stepped her game up. As you know, she did Wonderland. She has some artists working under her, but she's awesome. Check her out. It's a very empowering song, The Jangle Jang. Thanks everyone for watching. Like, subscribe, and share my videos with your friends. If you have anything that you want me to talk about in particular, you know, something saucy and fun, then send it to me. Let me know. I'll talk about it. Have a great day.